This is the day that the Lord has made. I will rejoice and be glad in it. Therefore, depression has no place to reside where the praise of God resides. I take authority over depression. I take authority over the spirit of heaviness that will try to come to overtake, that cloud that wants to come to overshadow. We know that the spirit of depression is not from the Lord. The Bible addresses depression. David said over in Psalms 42, verse 11, he says, "Why am I discouraged? Why is my heart so sad? I will put my hope in God. I will praise him again, my Savior and my God." The Message Bible says, "Why are you down in the dumps, dear soul? Why are you crying the blues? Fix my eyes on God. Soon I'll be praising again. He puts a smile on my face. Why? Because he is my God." So therefore, I know that God wants to put a smile upon my face. He's there to lift up my spirit. And therefore, depression, the strong man of depression, cannot reside in me any longer. We will deal with the roots of this spirit of depression. The roots, the symptoms of depression is hopelessness. It's helplessness, it's worthless, it's guilt, it's irritability, it's ashamed, it's being restless. You can, when you're battling with depression, you lose your concentration. It's hard to make decisions. You're not able to sleep at night. You don't want to go about and do the activities and the things that bring joy to your life. The enemy of depression, it wants to put you in a pit that breeds isolation, a pit that breeds despair. But we come together today, connected by faith, in faith, to take authority over depression. We decree and declare. We send the word of the Lord to bring healing to the listener right now. We send the Spirit of God to wherever you may be right now to speak Isaiah 61:3. The Bible says, "To appoint unto them that mourn in Zion, to give unto them beauty for ashes, the oil of joy for mourning, the garment of praise for the spirit of heaviness." So right now, God, in the name of Jesus, we thank you, Lord, for your word that tells us, God, that you, Father God, is giving us the joy, and the joy of the Lord shall be our strength. Depression shall not be the guide, but the joy of the Lord shall be our strength. We command right now, God, and we speak, God, to the hormones, God. We speak to the chemicals, God, that's in our bodies where depression will try to dormant itself, where it would try to bring a heaviness to. So we speak, God, to the serotonin, God. We speak, God, to the dopamine in our bodies that you created. You created our bodies according to Psalms 139. And it says that we are fearfully and that we are wonderfully made. So right now, Lord, we speak to serotonin. We speak to dopamine. We speak to those neurotransmitters, God. And we ask, Father God, and we thank you, Lord. We bring them into a balance, God. We bring them into homeostasis, Lord, in the name of Jesus, Father. Because, God, we know, Lord, that as we think on these things, as we think on things that are pure, as we think on things that are royal, as we think on things that are high and exalted, which you are, Father God, then it lifts us up in our spirits, God. So therefore, now, Lord, we come out of the spirit of depression, Father, and we put on the garment of praise, Lord, in the name of Jesus, Father. We thank you right now, God, that you are already meeting our needs because, God, you are the God of peace. According to your word in Isaiah 9:6, it says that Jesus is the Prince of Peace. So therefore, we thank you, God, that the peace of God rests upon us right now. So, Lord, in the name of Jesus, again, Father, we thank you, Lord God, that this spirit of depression, this spirit, this cloud world, Father, where the enemy wants us to reside. He wants us to think that this is our normal, but this is not our normal, because God, we bind that strong man in the name of Jesus, and we loose, God, your comfort. We loose, God, your garment of praise. We loose, God, your oil of joy in our lives right now, as we think on the goodness of Jesus and all that you have done for us. Our soul, God, shall cry out, hallelujah. We thank you, God, for blessing us. We thank you, Lord, that you're speaking to us right now, and you're saying to us, God, that you are pleased, Father, that we are crying out to you in our distress. We are not crying out to depression, but we're crying out to the living God right now. We lift up our hands to you, Lord, and we say that we love you, and we know, God, that you will meet every need and that you will minister to us. Why? Because you are our Heavenly Father and we are your children, and you desire, God, to be close to us. We will not let anything, including the depression, God, to come between us. We thank you, God, that you are giving us different thoughts, positive thoughts, God. We thank you, Father God, that you're casting down, God, by the power of your Holy Spirit, all negativity, all doubt, all fear, all condemnation. Because, God, we know that when these things come, it blocks, God, the flow. It blocks, God, the access that we have to you, Father. So right now, Lord, we come before the throne of grace boldly, and we step in our rightful places as men and women of God, and we take authority over depression, because we know that depression does not have a dwelling place. It does not dwell within us. We thank you, God, that we have examples in the word of God. We walk over to Elijah, and we thank God, Lord, for the word, Father, that there was a man of God that dealt with a spirit of heaviness. He dealt with a depressive state as the enemy came after him. And there are those under the sound of my voice that are dealing with an enemy that's coming after them, an enemy that's coming after their mind, an enemy that's coming after their relationships, an enemy that's coming after their financial situations, and wants to put them into this pit of depression, this pit of despair. But we speak to it right now in the name of Jesus, and we cast it out. And we thank you, Father God, that it's casted back into the pits of hell from whence it came. So therefore, God, we recognize, first of all, that there is an enemy of depression. And with our recognition, God, we come before you, Father, and we ask, God, for your forgiveness. We ask for your forgiveness, Lord God, because we have allowed that spirit, God, to come upon us. So right now, Father, according to your word, God, in 1 John 1 and 9, you said if we confess our sins, that you are faithful and just to forgive us of our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. God, so forgive us right now for not living in the freedom of Christ, of which he died on the cross for us to have, Lord. And we thank you for it right now, God. And now, God, we arise, because the Bible says that we cast down every imagination and every high thing that exalts itself against the knowledge of God. So therefore, we take authority over depression, and we rise, and we continue to rise above it, Lord. And as we rise above it, Father, we shall recover. We shall recover all. Therefore, God, we will walk, God, with our head up high. We will walk, God, in the goodness and the mercy of you, Father, knowing that grace and mercy is with us all our days, Father. And then we're going to put the word in us, God. We're going to put the word according to Psalms 139 in our spirits, Lord, in the name of Jesus. We're not going to allow the spirit of depression to speak to us, God. But Lord God, we're going to allow the word to speak to us. And Psalms 139 says that you know everything about us, God. You know our sitting down and our rising up, Father. Your word says, God, that we can never escape you, Father. If we make our bed in hell, then you are there, God. If we make our bed in heaven, God, then we know that you are already there as well. We thank you, Father God, that we are delicate in your eyesight. We are delicate in your hands, and you made our inner parts, which means, God, you know everything about us, and you knitted us together in our mother's womb. So therefore, God, we are fearfully and wonderfully made, God, and that is what we shall stand on, Lord, in the name of Jesus, God. We thank you, God, that you search us and that you know us, and anything that's not like us, Father, that's in us that's not like you, God, we rebuke and bind in the name of Jesus. Jesus. So therefore, the spirit of depression, it has to go. It has no dwelling place. It cannot reside where the praises of God reside. In Jesus' name, we do pray. Amen.